Bronchiolitis is an illness usually in the age range of 2 and less. So this is a little bit older mannequin, but we can at least still show some of the signs of respiratory distress that I would want to really describe to my parents when I see them in clinic, so that when they go home, they can be prepared to recognize the signs that their child is getting worse and might need to seek additional evaluation. So one thing that we always look for are what we call accessory muscle use. And this child is doing a pretty good job of this. You can see the rib cage is expanding in and out, and these are called intercostal retractions. So I usually describe it as the skin in between the ribs going in and out, in and out. And those muscles are helping to pull the rib cage open to suck in as much air as possible. And then the second thing that we see is the diaphragm and the abdomen. We call these subcostal retractions, also moving in and out, again in an attempt to breathe in as much oxygen as that child can. The third set of retractions are subcostal retractions, which we'll see the neck pulling in and out, and sometimes even causing the child to head bob a little bit. Once all three of these retractions are being used, this child's in respiratory distress, and we really want them evaluated by a medical provider. And this is really what we were looking for. I also assess for their hydration when they come to my clinic. So there's a couple signs of this. The biggest one for me is whether they're able to keep their mucous membranes moist. So I'll look at their lips, assess their eyes. Are they making tears when I'm evaluating them? And then, of course, the most important thing for kids 2 and under, are they making urine? That's easy. We can see their diapers. So if they're making wet diapers at least 2 or 3 a day, then they're staying hydrated enough for their body to be able to continue to support itself while they're fighting off this infection. If they're going close to a 24 hours without a urine, though, that's a great sign that their kidneys are holding on to every drop and that we're going to have to provide extra fluid for that child, either through an IV or sometimes just through a nasogastric tube, where we'll put the fluid, either Pedialyte or formula, straight into their gut.